Welcome to episode 26 of 100 Songs. Today, we're talking about a Rolling Stones cover of the song Under My Thumb, performed by Social Distortion, off of their 1996 album, White Light, White Heat, White Trash. Social Distortion was formed in 1978. They're from California. And they had their debut album in 1983. And right off the bat, they had, a little bit in, they started having some issues. Founder, singer, guitar player Mike Ness was struggling with a heroin addiction and did get his act together after that, after a couple of years. And it was the albums after that where they started to gain some real popularity and settled into a punk blues, country, honky-tonk sort of sound. Their roots are really in punk, I would say, but they did get into they did have an element of blues and country. So after a kind of a long hiatus, they returned and wanted to do something a little different, and that's when they did White Light, White Heat, White Trash. And it was like I said, it was 1996, and they went back to more of a hard rock sound. Still punk, but you could argue it was as much a hard rock album as it was a punk album, I would say. But that's what I like about it, actually. This is an album that I really enjoy because I like this sound and this style. So when this album came out, a friend of mine, who was my roommate at the time, was already a fan of Social Distortion. I was not. And then when this came out, he played it quite a bit, and it grew on me, and I ended up liking it a lot. And then I explored the rest of their catalog. But for me, this was my favorite of theirs by far. And, you know, I don't consider myself a big fan, but I do really like this album. And it also reminds me of a really fun time in my life. So there's always that too. You hear something and it takes you back, and we had a lot of fun those days. So I would say this was playing in the background sometimes. So it's what it reminds me of. Kind of a interesting side note, Chuck Biscuits is credited as being the drummer on this album. But he was really the drummer in the band at this point. He did not perform on this album, and I didn't know that until recently. At the time this came out, I was already a fan of Chuck Biscuits as a drummer because of his work with Danzig. And I really liked his style. He's a punk drummer, goes way back. Black Flag, Circle Jerks. Anyway, when I was listening to this and then I read the liner notes and saw that he was the drummer, I was like, oh, that's cool. I like Chuck Biscuits. But turns out he didn't do the drums on this album. It was a session drummer that did it. Doesn't matter. Doesn't change anything. I just thought it was interesting. So this particular song, I like the energy of it. It's a little bit faster, and it's just a hell of a fun song. Rest of the album is solid though too, in my opinion. There's a lot of really good songs on here. It's a good listen. So let's listen to part of Under My Thumb. We'll pick it up towards the beginning. So you get a taste of it, although that was probably close to half the song. It's a pretty short song. It's just under 3 minutes. It wasn't half the song. It was part of the song, I guess. But it goes like that for another verse, and then a little guitar solo at the end. I listened to the Rolling Stones version after several years, and I mean, they're totally different. One sounds like the Rolling Stones, and one sounds like Social Distortion. Mick Jagger, I believe, wrote this. I think Keith Richards and Mick Jagger are credited for this song. But I think Mick Jagger wrote the lyrics. And it's basically about being in a relationship with a woman that is a bit too dominant and controlling, and this is the coming out of that and taking control or whatever, something along those lines. So that's it for this song, Under My Thumb. Let's go to the wheel, see what we will be discussing next time. Okay, you, me, dancing. So this is from Los Campesinos. I love this song. It's a really cool song. This one was actually came to my attention because of my son. He's a big fan and plays this all the time, and it really grew on me. Along with a bunch of their other songs. I like several other songs, but this one I would say is my favorite. So we'll talk about that next time. Have a good one.